Playoff football returned to Buffalo last season for the first time in a quarter of a century.
And the Bills win it! They snap the third longest active playoff drought in the NFL that ends at 24 seasons.
This season, led by the NFL's number one defense.
We set the tone!
And a star quarterback.
Allen to Diggs, touchdown!
The Bills capture their second straight division title, bringing the playoffs to Buffalo once again. After a one-year absence, the New England Patriots are back in the postseason with a different look than perennial playoff teams of the past.
Jones, over the top he goes!
Touchdown, Patriots!
Familiar foes collide as tonight marks the third meeting between these two teams in the last 7 weeks.
He runs through a big hole! Damien Harris to the house!
Just flings it to Dawson Knox! Touchdown, Buffalo!
This time, it's win or go home.
Yeah!
It's an AFC East showdown on Super Wild Card Weekend. It's Saturday night in Western New York, and where else would you rather be? Extremely frigid conditions for round three of the Patriots and Bills, and the most important chapter of this division rivalry. The NFL playoffs on CBS from Orchard Park. Buffalo in the postseason for the third straight year. They are the number three seed in the AFC. New England is the sixth seed, a wild card for the first time under Bill Belichick. And we welcome you inside the broadcast booth, which is outside. And the weather is legit. Ian Eagle, Charles Davis, Evan Washburn down on the field. We'll have more on the weather coming up. You think about where the Bills were during the offseason. They were the popular pick to maybe come out of the AFC and go to the Super Bowl. But it's been a little bit of a bumpy road for Buffalo. Now they're playing potentially their best ball at the right time.
They certainly are 4-0 down the stretch. And, of course, a big reason, their quarterback, Josh Allen. When he's at the top of his game, he walks that fine line between structure and improvisation. In his last three games against New England, 8 touchdown passes, 0 interceptions. The rookie for New England, Mac Jones, last time they were here, he only threw it 3 times in the wind. Tonight, I expect him to throw it more, especially on first down, to keep them out of third long situations and keep drives going.
And Charles, the message we got from talking to both of these teams, we know them, they know us.
They certainly do. 3 times this year, 2 times every year for Bill Belichick. He wants his game not to be a track meet. He wants his defense to keep him in it so his offense can run the ball and control the clock. For Sean McDermott, when he looks at this game, it's simply this. For us to get where we want to go, guys, we have to slay that dragon that is New England one more time.
It is a clean slate when you get to the playoffs. The Pats and the Bills, the winner advances to the divisional round. Countdown to kickoff continues right here on CBS. And from Highmark Stadium, temperature currently 7 degrees, feels like minus 5. It's going to dip a little lower, and braving the elements, third member of our crew down on the field, Evan Washburn.
Yeah, and I can concur. And the Week 13 matchup between these two teams on this field was defined by gale force winds. Well, tonight, it's those Arctic temperatures. Important to note, though, this field, it's not heated underneath. It will continue to freeze over the course of this game, as will the footballs in this one. And that's where the teams are concerned. Game plan, scheme should not be affected. Ball security, though, should, both offensively and defensively. As for the mental hurdle of these conditions, Bill's safety, Micah Hyde, he put it best, saying early in this game, once the adrenaline wears off, you'll know who wants to be out here. Stay warm, boys.
Yeah, no doubt, Evan. Same to you. And here's the reality. Everybody's got to deal with it.
Yeah. Yeah. Just because you live in a certain place, you still got to go play and perform in it.
100%. Jake Bailey will kick it off for New England. Isaiah McKenzie is the deep man for Buffalo. The Bills, 11-6 this season. Back-to-back AFC East titles. New England, a wild card, something they have never been under Bill Belichick. 18th playoff appearance in the last 21 years. And away we go in Buffalo. Returnable at the 15, McKenzie. Takes a lane to the outside. Ball came loose right at the end, out of bounds. And he is dropped just across the 30-yard line by Brandon King on special teams. Josh Allen, the leader of this team, the face of the franchise. When we asked him about the conditions, he said there is no mental or physical way to prepare for it. You deal with it. You try to stay warm. The question for him was, can I throw a spiral? That's all I care about.
It doesn't matter about the arm angle. As long as he can throw a tight spiral, he'll drop down, he'll do whatever, and look for a lot of quarterback run game, including maybe some option out of them tonight.
Allen will throw it on first down. He delivers over the middle and hits Stephon Diggs. 9 yards. Diggs, what a season he put together. Another Pro Bowl campaign. This Buffalo offense this season finished number 5 in total offense, 3rd in scoring, nearly 28.5 points per game. Some stability on that offensive line. They liked the group that they put together. It was not the original group, though.
And the guys solidified it, Ryan Bates at left guard.
Second down and 1. Singletary came on late in the season. Got more carries. He'll get his first touch. Singletary carries some tacklers with him. And he's got a first down. Muscles his way across with Lawrence Guy holding on. And he picks up 4. This New England defense, when they had that 7-game winning streak, this defense was lights out. Last 4 games of the season, some slippage, but it worked part and parcel when the offense was starting to have some struggles.
Absolutely, and what they really need tonight, control the running game that Buffalo does present, and see if they can get the pass rush tuned up again. Matthew Judon, a Pro Bowler, no sacks in his last 4 games.
Sean McDermott, 5th year as the head coach of the Bills. Bill Belichick, 22nd year as the head man of the Patriots. Singletary sets up. And a 4-receiver look. Shotgun for Allen. They'll check it down. Singletary tries the spin, doesn't work. Good coverage by J.C. Jackson on the outside. Jalen Mills on the COVID list, so Jowan Williams stepping in for Mills. So no gain on the play.
It'll be interesting tonight if the Patriots do get Buffalo in 3rd down situations. What they do with Stephon Diggs, the Pro Bowl wide receiver, they normally don't double team. Tremendous 3rd down receiver. He shredded New England the last couple of times out.
That last meeting, week 16, Josh Allen was masterful. He was in full command. Second down and 10. Allen gets out of the pocket. We know how dangerous he is with his legs, and there he goes. Josh Allen, huge run across the 30-yard line. Matthew Judon was trying to chase him down. It's a 26-yard rip for Allen.
And once he decided to go, watch as he gets out in open field and becomes a one-on-one dance with Matthew Judon in open field, and Josh Allen wins it and continues upfield. And one thing about this big guy, he goes to the sideline here, but he's not a guy that often looks to slide. He wants to get every yard downfield, and he does it on that run.
First player in NFL history with over 4,000 passing yards and over 750 rushing yards in the same season. And a new set of downs for Buffalo to work with at the 31.
Wait, 20, what's that?
Allen, fake, steps up, and flings it low in the direction of Emmanuel Sanders. The veteran's been dealing with a knee injury himself. They are stacked at the wide receiver position with Diggs and Beasley, Sanders, Gabriel Davis, a contributor. Isaiah McKenzie stepped in when necessary a few weeks ago.
Two guys I'm really looking at tonight. Cole Beasley, remember, he didn't play in their last game, and Isaiah McKenzie stepped in big time for him. Beasley, he wants something, he's got something to prove tonight. Gabriel Davis, the first playoff game last year, he was dynamite against Indianapolis with 85 yards of catches.
That was a victory in the wild card round last year. Only 6,500 fans, though, in attendance. We got a full house tonight. Second down and 10. Allen, pump and throw to the sideline. It gets there for McKenzie, and he works his way upfield short of a first down. Jowan Williams, third year, second round pick from Vanderbilt, over on the perimeter. They pick up 7.
And that throw kept them out of 3rd and long. Because if he's not able to complete that one, and that's a throw not many quarterbacks can make. Totally standing still in the pocket, all arm all the way to the sideline. He turned down the throw across the middle, took the outlet, now sets up 3rd and short.
Fans here in Western New York have been waiting for this opportunity to cheer on the Buffalo Bills, a team that very well could make a run to the Super Bowl. Singletary in the backfield, fake it to him. Allen, design run. He's got the room. He's got the outside and a first down. Josh Allen picks up chunks of yards.
And watch how the center, Mitch Morris, number 60, comes around. Also out there is number 79, Spencer Brown. Then Josh Allen with a nice move and some power. That's simply a quarterback sweep for the Buffalo Bills. That's old single wing football. A lot of guys leading. 15 yards later, the Bills are in business inside the New England 10.
His mobility was a big part of the scouting report coming out of college, why the Bills were so excited about bringing him on board. First and goal, opening drive. Handoff. Singletary. Nowhere to go. 1 yard pickup with Judon all over it, the Pro Bowler for New England.
So here early, we've already seen one design quarterback run play. If we see Isaiah McKenzie get into the lineup and get into the backfield with two backs, him and Singletary, could be some option game coming as well. They want to utilize all the ability that Josh Allen brings to the table, that mobility that you just talked about.
Ninth play of the drive for Buffalo, second and goal. We hit the 10-minute mark of this opening quarter. Allen will operate from the gun. Fake it. Allen looking, waits. The patience. Allen turns the corner and he will toss it. Back in the end zone. Touchdown. Catch made. It is Dawson Knox. And the Bills strike first on an excuse me touchdown from Josh Allen.
Look at Knox elevate to make the catch.
There is no foul for rushing the passer. The ruling on the field is a touchdown.
Spencer Brown gets just enough of the defender there to give him a chance. He throws it up high. Kyle Duggar playing with a big cast on his hand. He missed last week against Miami with that injury. He can't go with that hand to make a play. Knocks over the top of his helmet, hauls it in. And you mentioned, excuse me, touchdown. There's a messed up route on the opposite side of the field, which made Josh Allen exit the pocket and look to be creative on the other side.
There's that moment where you feel like Josh Allen just accepts, all right, it's not going to happen here. I'll just toss it to the back and let's see what happens.
And put it in a position where let's see what can happen is favorable in his position because it's Dawson Knox going up to get it, a trust factor.
I mean, obviously this was a completely different stage when it happened, but that's Montana Dwight Clark territory.
It's also Josh Allen to Dawson Knox last year.
Yeah.
In this playoff game. Very similar type of a play where he ended up creating and it paid off.
Touchdown is confirmed. Tyler Bass is on for the extra point, having an outstanding season. And he drills it. Nine plays, 70 yards. The connection, Allen to Knox. Knox had 9 touchdowns during the regular season. Josh Allen, surgical in his approach on the opening drive at home. Not sure the Bills could have scripted it much better than that opening drive to go 9 plays, 70 yards, and to cash in with that play, Josh Allen showing off all of his skills over the course of that possession.
Certainly felt like offensive coordinator Brian Daboll, whatever he did script, he didn't have to get off of it. They never got into a situation where he had to go to an alternate play call. Didn't even get to third down that much on that drive. Big time drive, great opening statement by Buffalo. And New England, who does not want this to be a track meet, they've got to come back with an answer quickly.
Tyler Bass, booming kick. Olszewski's going to take it out. And hit across the 10. Olszewski got stoned by Saran Neal. The New England Patriots offense led by Mac Jones, the 5th quarterback taken in the draft, but the best numbers of any rookie QB. Passing yards, completion percentage, and touchdowns. Mac Jones stepped forward, got the job in the preseason, and has certainly carried himself like a veteran at times this year. Running play on the opening drive. Damian Harris has 3 straight 100-yard games against Buffalo, and he gains 2 with forward progress. Taron Johnson and Dane Jackson combined to bring him down. On this offensive line, should be noted, Isaiah Wynn, ankle injury last week. in that loss in Miami. So Justin Herwan starts at the left tackle spot. The rest of the line remains as is. Jacoby Myers this season, the leading receiver for the Patriots. Second down and eight. Jones threw it just three times in the first meeting. Outside catch made and a slip after the grab by Bourne. Good enough for a first down. Matched up with Levi Wallace on the outside.
This is something the Buffalo fans did not get to see much of the first time Mac Jones actually throwing the football. Remember, only three throws in that first game in the 50-mile-per-hour winds. But how about that on second and eight? Big strike to the wide side of the field right out of the gate. The young man shows confidence with his first throw.
Charles, New England will go with an extra offensive lineman, Owenu, and we'll keep you updated when we see it. Play fake, and the play is whistled dead. It's Brad Allen, seventh-year referee.
False start. Offense number 47. Five-yard penalty. Still first down.
The fullback, Jakob Johnson, called on the false start. Back it up for the Pats.
And you mentioned Owenu coming in as the extra offensive lineman. 26 times in the first meeting against Buffalo here. They ran for 163 yards when he was on the field. That's their power set that they like to go to.
Josh McDaniels, 18th year with the Pats in two separate stints. Calling the plays for New England. First and 15, they'll stick with that extra offensive lineman. Buffalo leads it 7-0. Pitch it. Harris. Had some running room and the hole closed up in a hurry. Harrison Phillips, who's had a breakout season for Buffalo in his fourth year with a tackle. It's a one-yard pickup. This is the number one defense overall, number one scoring defense as well. We talked to Micah Hyde about that. We asked him, sense of pride? He goes, yeah,
absolutely.
The goal is to be the best. They were the best this year.
And where they really excel? Long yardage situations. Here they got New England in second and long already. You get to third and long, and they suffocate teams.
Second down and 14 for New England. 7.5 to go in this opening quarter. Shotgun, Jones steps, throws, incomplete. Sliding there was Bourne. And Taron Johnson drew the assignment on the outside. It's third and long.
Trying to go back to the outer part of the field as he did on his first throw of the ball game. This time, his pass a little bit low, unable to come up with it. But here's where Buffalo excels. Gets their speed on the field. Third and long. Expect pressure to come at Mac Jones on this snap. Let's see if New England wants to counter and possibly run the football and just get out of here on this drive.
And we look at third down conversion rates, but you got to go deeper. Third and eight or more, they converted a 17% clip this season. That's the second lowest in the NFL. New England on third and 14. Pressure. Jones gets out of trouble, throws it downfield, and it's caught by Henry. Big play, New England. Hunter Henry gets open for 31 yards.
Big play, huge confidence builder. One thing Mac Jones doesn't do is take off and run with the football. Has one of the fewest scramble, one of the lowest scramble rates in the league for quarterbacks. But what he does do is extend, keep his eyes downfield, and his receivers understand that. And Hunter Henry breaks off his route, finds an open spot, and picks up a key first down.
Henry, first year with New England, 9 touchdowns, tying Kelsey and Andrews for the most among tight ends in the NFL. Brandon Bolden is in. First down. Jones from midfield. Put some zip on it. Downfield, dropped. Bolden, who has been so rock solid catching the football, had a career year in the receiving category, could not bring it in.
Could not ask for a better opportunity. Something we anticipated going into the game. First down throws from Mac Jones to try and loosen up the defense a little bit and not run up against a brick wall. And when you have a shot like that, you've got to complete it. Brandon Bolden won't drop many, but that was a big one.
And there was separation there with A.J. Klein. It would have been a huge play downfield. Instead, it's second and 10. Harris in the backfield, 6:32 to go in the first. Jones. Two Pats in the area, and that pass was dropped by Myers.
Is that tipped out by the first one? I know there were two in the area. looked a little bit off. Looked like it was tipped by the first receiver, and the second receiver couldn't haul it in.
Yep.
Right there. Just a glance off the fit, off of his hand, and it takes it away from Jacoby Myers.
Eighth play of the drive.
Third and 10 for New England. Showing a lot of pressure at the line of scrimmage.
Two back off. Jones steps up, looking for room. Jones trying to run, and Jones has got the first down. Epinesa put the heat on Jones. He loops out of trouble for 16 and keeps the drive alive.
The evolution of a quarterback, the evolution of a rookie quarterback. Did I just not say a couple of plays ago this is not something he does very often? Well, when necessary, playoff football, you improvise and you do things out of character. And Mac Jones running for a first down, not something you see very often.
And they have converted 2 third and longs on this possession. Jones had just 129 yards rushing this season. Jones, pump, rifle downfield. Intercepted. Sliding catch made by Hyde for the pick.
Rolling on the field is an interception. Touched by Buffalo. First down.
Micah Hyde, second team All-Pro, and what a play. Aguilar, the intended target. Turnover, New England. A Bills defense comes through on its opening drive against New England.
Let's go!
Highmark Stadium in Orchard Park, New York, rocking early. We just saw a brilliant play for Micah Hyde.
Yeah, sometimes it's not a mistake that happens. It is just a brilliant play. Because Mac Jones threw a perfect football. Micah Hyde just made a better play on the ball.
So the Bills take over at the 20-yard line. Buffalo has allowed just one opening drive touchdown in their last 29 games, including this one. Allen. And puts it downfield. And he's got Knox wide open. Perfectly thrown for 24 yards.
And perfectly surveyed by Josh Allen to take in the whole field before picking out his target and then delivering perfectly. Dawson Knox out of the gate fast. Run a nice little over route. Perfectly thrown football by Josh Allen.
Dawson Knox told us a couple of weeks ago it all clicked this year. Just everything slowed down for him, and that chemistry that he's developed with Josh Allen has been apparent. Temperature is down to 6 degrees. Allen tosses to the outside, stumbling. And the catch made by Emmanuel Sanders. Modest gain, 2 yards with Miles Bryant there defensively. One thing for the Buffalo Bills, Charles, you look at their wins. They won 11 games this season. All 11 of their wins came by 12 points or more. They didn't win the close ones. When they won convincingly.
Absolutely, and that's what both of these teams are conscious of, is that if Buffalo gets out and plays at that pace, that's their style of game. New England much more comfortable if the game's in the low 20s in terms of scoreboard.
Patriots lost 3 of their last 4 games to end the regular season after the bye. It's McKenzie. Good speed to the outside. High-energy player, Isaiah McKenzie. Getting a touch, Jawan Williams defending that area. He picks up some.
And remember that play, Isaiah McKenzie going into the backfield and becoming a runner. Down the road, he may be the guy who becomes the trailback on an option pitch with Josh Allen.
Sean McDermott, we asked him about that second New England game. He said the motivation was there after the first one. He passed along the message how the team has to be aligned as a group, one heartbeat, everybody working at the same cadence, and so far, so good for Buffalo. Singletary rumbling through for a first down, so that'll move the chains for the Bills, 6 yards.
And they ended up bringing in Tommy Doyle, the rookie out of Miami of Ohio. The massive 6'8", 320-pound tackle as an extra offensive lineman. New England loves to run that type of formation with Owenu coming in next to Trent Brown. This time Doyle lines up on the right side, and they run behind him with Spencer Brown providing the extra effort.
The loss for Buffalo in the first meeting between these two teams, the adverse weather conditions, it was so dispiriting because of the way New England manhandled them. Play action. Down at the line of scrimmage, incomplete. So that second game, you and I were there in Foxborough. We asked Josh Allen about it. He said there was so much going on emotionally, we had to let it out. It
died, and they run behind him with Spencer Brown providing the extra effort.
The loss for Buffalo in the first meeting between is based on the first meeting and based on everything that's built up in this division over the years.
Yeah, the absolute frustration, thinking that last year they had taken care of New England and kind of had their way in the series. And then once again, they were chasing New England. They wanted to get back and reassert themselves. They did in Foxborough, trying to do it again here against a very tough New England defense.
Lawrence Guy got a piece of that pass from Allen. It's second and 10 in this opening quarter, 7-0 Bills. Play action. Allen sets, throws it downfield. Leaping grab made. McKenzie climbs the ladder for a first down. It covers 19 yards for Buffalo, and the Bills are in business once again.
Look at the route. Now, what he did is counter to what he did against New England in the first game. Because in the first game, Ian, as you remember, a lot of crossing routes that Isaiah McKenzie ran along the way to 11 catches. This time, he shows the crossing route, bends it back outside, and then absorbs the hit that he knew was coming on the pass from Josh Allen.
And Charles, give credit to this offensive line. They've allowed just one sack in the last 3 weeks. Deion Dawkins did a terrific job on that previous play, redirecting the defender. We approach 2 minutes to go. Here in the first, low throw. And Diggs couldn't handle it. Incomplete.
Yeah, and they had it there, and that's just one of those ones that Josh Allen's going to say to himself, just a count longer, take your time, and put the ball in the receiver. You know how Aaron Rodgers can throw from any arm angle, never seems to move his feet? There's a lot of that going on now. Josh Allen, just go ahead and use your mechanics, put the ball on him, and you've got a better play.
Sean McDermott very happy with the way that Diggs and Beasley in particular have held up late in the season compared to a year ago. They were banged up at this point last year.
But they did a good job of what do we call it, load management.
Yes.
In the NBA. They did a good job managing their time, their minutes, their reps throughout the season.
From the 22, this is a second and 10. Allen, strong throw to the outside. Diggs secures it. And he is out of bounds. Last 2 years, Stephon Diggs has been targeted 331 times, the most in the NFL.
And this is the matchup we expected to see. All-pro corner, second-team All-Pro, J.C. Jackson. 8 interceptions on the year. Stephon Diggs going back to another Pro Bowl. One-on-one, J.C. Jackson rises to the challenge. And Stephon Diggs has had the better of that matchup the last few times out. I'm eager to see on third down, do they give him a little bit of help with Stephon Diggs?
Third down and 4 for Buffalo. A 4 receiver set. Allen, they run it. First down. Going up the gut. The seas parted for Josh Allen.
Watch Mitch Morse, number 60, the center. He gets his block, he climbs the second level. Darrell Williams handles his business at the right guard position. And Josh Allen is the type of quarterback that in film session, defensive backs say, hey coach, aren't quarterbacks supposed to slide? I mean, you see 240-pound hurtling at you like that and dropping the shoulder, not normal from the quarterback position.
Bills are knocking on the door again. First and 10, just shy of the 10. Fake. Allen. A laser beam. Dawson Knox. Touchdown, Buffalo.
Skinny post, or what they call a bang 8. And look at Dawson Knox, right foot in the ground. And all he does is get his body in front of Adrian Phillips. An excellent safety. But because he's able to body him off like it's a basketball play, walls him off. Would you call that again, Ian? Laser shot. There it is, right between the 8 and 8. Touchdown, Buffalo.
Two long drives. One was 70 yards. The next, 80 yards. This one off the interception for Micah Hyde. Tyler Bass knocks it through. Buffalo is feeling like Allentown right now. 14-0 Bills in front. Super Wild Card Weekend continues tomorrow, a triple header, and concludes Monday night in LA. And then the NFL Divisional Playoffs presented by Intuit TurboTax Live kick off next weekend on CBS, Fox, and NBC. Buffalo Bills, the only team in the NFL in the top five in scoring offense and scoring defense, and we have seen both out there doing their thing in this opening quarter. 14-0 lead for Buffalo. Pass will kick it off. Olszewski is the deep man for New England. This has been a recurring issue for the Patriots, getting down in these games early and then having to battle back from a deep hole. Coming out to the 25. Consider the league's most prestigious honor. The Walter Payton NFL Man of the Year Award recognizes NFL players who have not only exhibited excellence on the field, but whose passion to impact lives extends beyond the game, and it's led them to leave a positive legacy in their communities. This year's nominee for the Patriots, Lawrence Guy, the Bills, Harrison Phillips. Guy continued his holiday tradition. Shop with a Jock hosted his annual backpack giveaway. Phillips hosted his football camp for those with special needs, encouraged kids to give back to their communities. This year's winner will be announced at NFL Honors on Thursday, February 10th, 9 p.m. Eastern on ABC, ESPN Plus, and NFL Network. Delayed handoff for Damian Harris. Patriots trying to establish the running game here. 4.5 yard gain. Good block from Shaq Mason up front to help spring Harris loose.
And this game is not 14-0 because New England's offensive strategy is off. The strategy's been right and the execution's been there. Just a terrific interception by Micah Hyde has turned the tide. And Buffalo's offense, unstoppable here in the early going.
Second down and 6. And they will not get a playoff here at the end of the first quarter. We go to the second in frigid Buffalo. The Bills 14, the Patriots nothing. AFC wildcard action here on CBS. Images from the 4 coldest games in NFL history, the coldest being the Ice Bowl, and this is going to fit somewhere on a larger list. Currently 6 degrees, it was 7 at kickoff. Damian Harris cuts to the outside, first play of the second quarter, and he's spilled out on a hit by Tremaine Edmonds. So minus 13, the NFL Championship 1967. The Freezer Bowl, the Chargers and the Bengals, minus 9, 1981. You had the Seahawks and the Vikings in that NFC wildcard game, 2015. You had the purplish hue on the face of Tom Coughlin in Green Bay in that playoff game. It's bitter cold here.
Yeah, but Bud Grant went out in a polo shirt for that game for the coin toss.
Yeah, I chose not to go polo shirt tonight. Third down and 3. Toss it. Can Harris get the angle? Right at the line, and it appeared to be short on the initial look.
Mario Addison gave a great chase there, and if he didn't get it, it's because of the effort by Addison, because Harris couldn't truly turn the corner. Look at Addison, 97 in hot pursuit, and greets him at the angle. That little push, did he get there? They got to determine it.
No, he's short.
Look at Addison's hustle right there. You see him get a hand on him right at the end before he can get to the marker.
Yeah, Charles, I'm looking at the spot right now. It's well short.
Yeah.
Almost 2 yards short.
He wasn't able to get that shoulder turned up field to get that last step in bounds to give him a chance at the first down.
Micah Hyde does not normally return punts, but he's back there right now at the 18-yard line. Jake Bailey to kick it. High sailing kick. Fair catch. And he brings it in. 46-yard punt. Dealing with the conditions here in Western New York. Jones and Allen so far. It's Allen and the Bills having their way. Last 5 games of the season, we saw Josh Allen using his legs even more. It's such a weapon, and we've seen it already today. 3 carries, 46 yards, a long of 26. Bills take over, first and 10 at the 19. Allen, touch and throw, and it glances off the hand of the intended receiver, Gabriel Davis. Let's take a look at next-gen stats powered by AWS.
Look at Josh Allen, that evade rate. You talked about all what he can do with his legs and the mobility. And not only does he evade, he picks up yardage at the end. And then how about this? The Williams brothers with the Jets, Quinnen and then his brother Quincy, both can't get him down. And he fires that shot to Stephon Diggs for a touchdown.
Singletary in the backfield, he'll get the call. Slashing to the 27 and a half yard line. Picks up about 9 yards on the play. You know, something about going against Bill Belichick quarterbacks, you'll have a rough night's sleep the night before, but in talking to Josh Allen, it feels like he's at peace with what comes with that territory.
Yeah, and what comes with it is just understanding that you don't over-prepare. And that's what Josh Allen said. He is a reactionary-type quarterback, adjust as you go, and he also trusts his talents and the talent around him to be better than what Bill Belichick throws at him.
Extra offensive lineman, they need a yard. They get more than a yard with Singletary, and he picks up 3. The man called Motor gets it done as we check in with Evan.
And part of that, guys, too, for Allen, his focus in this one, not about adjustments or chess match, about IDing at the line. He said, look, being at home, it helps. When you're playing this defense, it's all about making that initial ID at the line of scrimmage before the snap.
Yeah, and Evan, he said, I'm a reaction type of QB. Trust my eyes. And he recognizes the fact that Belichick brings certain players into his defense that fit the system. They're versatile. They're hybrid. Allen is obviously, like everybody else, watched a ton of film on New England. 14-0 lead for the Bills. Sells the fake. Allen slings it out to Singletary with a catch made at the 36 for 5 yards. And the emergence of Singletary has also been a nice addition for Buffalo late in the season.
Look at the ball handling here by Josh Allen. Reminds me of our colleagues, Boomer Esiason and Phil Sims in their prime. Boomer especially was a magician with the football in the backfield, hiding it on play fakes. And how about Josh Allen there? Instead of throwing it deep, took the short pass.
Got the flag.
Illegal contact. Defense, number 54. 5 yard penalty. First down.
See, that type of play with all that ball handling, that's designed to get someone open deep. It's not there. And that penalty on Dante Hightower, past the 5 yard mark, understood that he saw the penalty and was able to get an easy completion, even though he couldn't get the ball deep as he wanted to.
No flag against Dante Hightower, the 10-year veteran.
That's past the 5 yard mark when Dante Hightower put the hit on him and dropped him to the ground.
So, first down at the 36. Alert here for Josh Allen. 23rd offensive play of the half. Allen sidesteps, fires, complete. Davis with the catch, and another Buffalo first down. 22 yards through the air.
And this offensive line that you talked about at the top of the show, coming together, having more continuity, an offensive line they like. Look at the time they gave Josh Allen. And then Gabriel Davis, who dropped the last pass that came to him, he wasn't dropping this one. Look at him reaching back and then bringing it to his body. When this drive started, we knew it was a little bit dire for New England. They needed a big stop here. Things are really escalating now as Buffalo continues to march.
And Allen has spread it around. 6 different receivers in this first half. Straight back. Allen. Trying to break free. He does. Allen makes a cut. And another strong run. It was a whiff by the rookie Barmore, who's dealing with an injury. Barmore was a question mark this week with a knee.
And look at who he runs through. You're talking about Barmore, the rookie, 6'5", 310 out of Alabama. Josh Allen gets that 240 of his going in the right direction. Runs through the attempted tackle. And look at the yards after the contact. Picks up 8 on the game.
He's got 54 rushing yards in the first half. Couple of touchdown passes to Knox.
Combination of called runs and his own scrambles.
Bills are closing in on 200 yards of offense. Handoff. Singletary bursts through doesn't quite get the first down with a flag thrown. Hightower there to hit him, and some words exchanged between Singletary and Hightower at the end of the play. Mentioned Singletary is known as Motor. He said he was Little Motor. His dad was Motor until high school. Then he took over the Motor nickname.
Personal foul. Grasping the face mask. Defense, 95. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
It is Equale called on the penalty.
You don't get that call very often, but a lot of the hand fighting inside when you're trying to rush the passer or trying to get to the runner. Sometimes the hand gets up in the mask area, and this time it's the defense. Ordinarily, that's going to be called on an offensive lineman pass protecting.
Bill Belichick going against a team in Buffalo that was plus 194 in point differential this season. Number one in the NFL, highest in franchise history. Full receiver set at the 17-yard line, and a timeout called by New England. Bills up 14-0. We'll come back in 30 seconds after this from State Farm. All Bills so far, 14-0 lead, 194 yards of offense. New England has been held to 67. Mac Jones intercepted on a tremendous sliding kick by Micah Hyde. And the Bills are driving once again. Motion man Davis, shotgun. Give for Singletary. Good vision by Singletary to cut it back and drive forward for four. He was hit by Barmore on the play.
On that New England sideline, Steve Belichick, the defensive play caller. Bill Belichick, obviously the head coach with a heavy hand in the defense, thinking to their trying to transmit that message to their defense. We need this stop here. We got to hold them to three at this point. Try and keep our offense in this game.
Running play again. Singletary. Inside the five. Knifing through. Good block from Bates. 9-yard pickup. Singletary is gaining steam.
And so is the offensive line of the Buffalo Bills to the right side now. That's the rookie Spencer Brown. That's Darrell Williams. Look at them come off the ball. And then look, folding around is Ryan Bates, who had been a journeyman backup at all positions. He moved in at left guard about 5 games ago, and he solidified this offensive line with terrific play. And Devin Singletary, the beneficiary on that carry.
First and goal, inside the 5. Stop and go by Singletary, slides low for 2 yards. We are under 8 minutes to play in this first half. Dietrich Wise Jr. will get credit for the tackle.
I don't care who you, what offensive system you see, where you go. I haven't met an offensive lineman yet that doesn't prefer run blocking and beating up people at the line of scrimmage. Buffalo's offense has that now. This could be a time now you come back with your quarterback, Josh Allen, with another quarterback power run play and try and get in the end zone.
Bills have already cracked 100 yards rushing in the first half. Second and goal. Buffalo trying to add to its lead. Singletary steamrolls in. Touchdown, Bills. Singletary caps it off for Buffalo.
Look at those big guys in blue just zone blocking. Take the person who's in your path and try and move them. To the left was Deion Dawkins, 73, going to his first Pro Bowl. Ryan Bates, 71, the center. Mitch Moore, 60. All of them working to the left side. Not only did Singletary score, so did the offensive linemen, taking their guys into the end zone with them.
Bills were number 6 in the NFL in rushing this season. They have been fantastic in this first half, every aspect of the offense.
Remember we said New England did not want this to become a track meet? Starter's pistol has been fired.
So that's 3 long drives. And those are crushing blows to take for the New England defense. So we're going to take a look. All scoring plays are reviewed. We'll step aside, come back with the verdict. Currently 20-0, Buffalo. Touchdown has been confirmed for Singletary, so 20-0 advantage for Buffalo.
Please reset the game clock to 7:20. 7:20 on the game clock, please.
No problem. We'll add 4 seconds.
Spirit of collaboration.
Yeah. Brad
Please
Allen wants it.
To 7:20.
He is in
Thank
charge.
You.
You're welcome. It's done.
The rapport continues.
It's important to get to know the officials on a human level.
Especially Ed Camp, since he's a conscientious reporter.
Tyler Bass on for the extra point. And it's blocked. The one thing that has not gone right in this first half for Buffalo. So the Bills have to settle for a 20-0 lead. Back in 30 seconds after this from Progressive Insurance. Tyler Bass was 51 of 51 on point after attempts during the regular season. That was blocked by Dietrich Wise Jr. for New England. And the Patriots is trying to get something going here. Very limited on offense. Matt Jones is 2 of 6 for 39 yards. Harris has 12 yards on the ground. Defensively, right now, Buffalo is just doing whatever it wants to do against this New England D.
But that block is the type of block that shows up if this game changes, if things flip, if New England gets back into it. That's why you play hard on every snap. Maybe that block, I don't know if it ignites anything, but it could make a difference down the road if New England gets going.
Tyler Bass kicks it off. Olszewski from the 5. Patriots need something, a lift. And Olszewski gets hit at the 22-yard line. Well, just when you thought football couldn't get any more fun, here comes Nickelodeon, an NFL wildcard game. You can't miss. Experience football like nowhere else. When the San Francisco 49ers take on the Dallas Cowboys in the wildcard game on Nickelodeon tomorrow, 4:30 Eastern. It's going to be wilder than ever.
I have to tell you, last week when we were promoting it, I got slimed. Yeah. Definitely one of the highlights of my career.
Big reaction.
That was very cool.
Your family was very excited.
Very excited. I think they might do it themselves for real.
First down from the 21. Jones. Touch pass. Stevenson. And a rookie from Oklahoma makes a move upfield for a gain of 4 through the air. Levi Wallace helping out to make that tackle on the perimeter. So if you're New England, you've now watched them on offense here through the first half. Something need to change? Do they have to make an adjustment?
I think that their game plan has been sound, right? Micah Hyde made one of the best interceptions we've seen all year that blunted the first drive on a really good throw by Mac Jones. And since then, it's been hard to keep up with what they're doing. The firepower a little bit different on New England's side of the ball versus Buffalo's.
Aguilar motion man, Jones deep drop, protection holds up. He lays it out there and nobody home. Hunter Henry, the closest Patriot to the football, and it's 3rd and 6.
So now you're dealing with a defense that's playing with uber confidence, ultimate confidence. I'm thinking here, extra pressure at Mac Jones, trying to get the young rookie off his mark as he tries to make this throw.
We talk about playoff week with Mac Jones. He said, we do things in a similar fashion every week here. It's a big game, but we need to have that same approach. And Jones is nowhere close to Aguilar in a flag thrown. Wallace and Poyer back there defensively.
Yeah, and they're going to get Levi Wallace and really an unnecessary play.
Pass interference. Defense, number 39. By rule, the ball is placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
See, watch Wallace. He gets beat a little bit off the line of scrimmage. Watch the inside hand. See how it just stays there on the receiver? If he just runs next to the receiver, the result's the same. Instead, he's got a hand out there forcing an official to see it stay on his body for a few yards,
and make him pull his flag. 22-yard penalty on that play.
Wenu in there, extra offensive lineman, first down running play. Stevenson took that hole and picks up 3 yards to the 50-yard line. A rookie quarterback has never taken his team to the Super Bowl. We've seen rookies win playoff games. Not a whole lot, but in somewhat recent fashion, if you want to call it recent, Mark Sanchez, Joe Flacco going all the way back, Ben Roethlisberger.
Russell Wilson was the last one, I believe, in 2012.
Last five first-round rookie QBs to start a playoff game. Sanchez, Luck, RG3, Lamar Jackson, and Matt Jones tonight. Second down and 7, just short of midfield. We're at the 5:37 mark of the second quarter. Jones, look out! Jones gets smothered at the 40-yard line. The rush came quickly for Buffalo. Star Lotulelei gets in there, and it's a loss of 10.
Just overwhelmed Shaq Mason. Did a good job with his hands to throw him aside, and then had a direct pass to Mac Jones, unable to get the ball out of his hands and get it downfield. Well, Tulele has lost his starting job to Harrison Phillips, had a few injuries down the stretch, out with COVID, but he showed up here tonight.
They had 8 sacks last week against the Jets, the most in the game under Sean McDermott. He also held the Jets to 53 yards of total offense. 3rd and 15. Play clock at 0.
Third down.
Rookie quarterback, playoff game on the road.
Bills Mafia getting involved themselves.
Big time.
They haven't seen a home playoff game in a long time. They're here to be a part of it.
3rd down and 20 for New England. Jones, bobbled, caught by Bolden, well short of a first down, out to the 49. They pick up 12, eventually tackled by Taron Johnson. So the Patriots will punt once again.
Only consolation on that drive is they moved it well enough that hopefully they can get some field position and assist their defense. 22-yard penalty with Levi Wallace gave him a little bit more of an opening. Helps out the punter here.
Again, Micah Hyde is back there. The trust factor with Hyde. They know he's going to make the right play. And Hyde will just dart out of bounds. No reason to even give the Patriots an opportunity to smack the ball out of there. A 42-yard kick, 3-yard return, 20-0 lead, Buffalo. Aerial coverage of tonight's game provided by Goodyear. Sure, they're pumping the heat in the blimp.
It better be.
It's freezing.
If it's cold here and you're up in the blimp, it's real cold.
It's the weekend and I can't feel my face.
Well played, sir.
Line of scrimmage is the 11-yard line to open up for Buffalo. Allen checks it down to McKenzie. Catch and run. The raw speed of Isaiah McKenzie. 19 yards.
Talk about evolution of a quarterback with Mac Jones. How about with Josh Allen? Because he wants to throw the ball downfield every play. He wants to be that gunslinger type of a guy. But the way teams are playing, sometimes they force you to take the checkdowns, and he was very decisive in going to that quickly and fashioning a very nice play downfield.
The Bills with 3 straight touchdown drives. Trying to make it 4. Allen, deep shot. Over the shoulder grab. Stephon Diggs against J.C. Jackson. An elite matchup, and Diggs wins the battle for 45 yards.
And this was not supposed to be a one-on-one man-to-man coverage. It was cover 3, 3-deep zone. J.C. Jackson has the outside third. But Stephon Diggs just ran past him, and there's no way a free safety from the middle of the field can get over and make a play on the ball. Josh Allen, Stephon Diggs, another nice hookup.
and a nice job by Diggs regulating his speed in order to come back enough for the football to finish off the play.
275 yards of offense for the Bills. Play clock winding down. Allen will take a timeout.
Charge timeout. Buffalo, you're first.
Think Josh Allen's into it. More second quarter action when we come back. Buffalo Bills 20, New England Patriots nothing. Wild card game here in Orchard Park, New York. Bills looking for more. 2:24 to go in this second quarter. Beasley motion man, fake the handoff. Allen, he's going to run it. The juke move by Allen in the slide. Right near the line to gain. Allen gains 9.
Good vision. Didn't have the throw he wanted. And there's the juke you described. That's Devontae Bosby, who just was brought up for this ball game.
And we hit the 2-minute warning with Buffalo in front. The league's 88 best players are set to face off on the Pro Bowl field in Las Vegas. Catch the 2022 Pro Bowl presented by Verizon Sunday, February 6th. 3 p.m. Eastern. Buy your tickets today at ProBowl.com or watch the excitement on ABC, ESPN, and ESPN Deportes.
Gabe Davis territory if they want to find it.
Second down and one. Singletary straight ahead. Cut to the outside. Singletary all the way. Touchdown, Buffalo. It's a clinic. Four drives, four touchdowns, 300 yards of offense in the first half.
Or you take number 41, Reggie Gilliam, utilize Ryan Bates, 71, and bring them around to lead for Devin Singletary. You don't need to find Gabe Davis in the end zone. You just hand it to the man named Motor and show him the finish line.
Year number 3 for Devin Singletary. We asked him what's been the biggest difference. He had a trainer in the offseason because of COVID. He did not have a trainer between years 1 and 2. Extra point is good from Bass. And Singletary has got a pair of touchdowns tonight. The Bills celebrating here in the first half. Buffalo Bills, first NFL team with 4 touchdowns on their first 4 drives since the 2018 AFC Divisional. Patriots against the Chargers in that postseason. Singletary's a Florida kid. And we asked him about the weather. He said, hey, I don't like wearing sleeves. Put a little Vaseline on those arms. He said, there's no running from the weather. Once you take the field, you don't even think about it. You don't talk about it. We live in it. So we just go out and do what we have to do.
And when you're up 27-0,
yeah,
you're a lot warmer.
Yeah, it does feel a little warmer on that sideline, doesn't it?
Let's take a look at how these Buffalo Bills are getting it done with Josh Allen leading them. Look at him seeing the field. Look at him looking left. Goes to the middle, goes back right, and then comes back left with a beautiful shot to Dawson Knox. Pocket movement. He doesn't have to be a runner all the time. He's a willing passer and make sure he finds his man downfield. That time is Gabe Davis. Now look at him, look left, hold the defense, and it was a cover 3 deep zone, and the backside corner saw him look left, throttled down, and Stephon Diggs ran past him.
Mac Jones in the air, catch is made by Kendrick Bourne for a first down. He's headed downstairs to Evan Washburn.
Guys, key defensive injury for the Patriots. Jawan Bentley, leading tackler, linebacker, questionable with the arm injury. He was not out there for that drive where the Bills just marched down the field.
Yeah, Bentley had 17 tackles last week in that loss to Miami, 33-24. Milano with a big hit on Brandon Bolden. Down to 135 and counting left in this first half.
I know everyone can't make the Pro Bowl, but Matt Milano, he had a Pro Bowl type season.
Second down and 8. Jones directing traffic. Catch is made at the 41, and then two Bills make sure to get over there against Bolden. They pick up 4.5. Getting down in these games, it's been a huge issue for New England. Their last three losses, they were outscored 54-7 combined to open those games. Bolden ducks out of bounds, and he's got enough for the first down. Coming up, Verizon Halftime Report, JV, Phil, Boomer, Coach Cower, all the latest NFL scores and highlights. They look very cozy in that studio. It's all coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report.
That didn't sound envious at all.
First down for the Pats out near midfield. Mac Jones steps up. Jones going to run and make sure that he gets down before absorbing a hit. But the clock continues to roll. Picks up a couple of yards. Down to 45 seconds left. New England has two timeouts remaining. A rush to the line. Jones fakes the spike and gets sacked on the play. Jerry Hughes was not faked. The longest tenured Bill gets home.
From the right side of your screen, he sees the fake. It just runs around Trent Brown to get to the quarterback in the pocket.
It'll be 30 seconds. Please set the game clock to 30 seconds.
That wave was a, oh, come on. You're really not trying that, are you?
Thank you.
Remember, the Bills drafted Greg Rousseau and Boogie Basham this year to pump up their pass rush. Jerry Hughes kind of gone to the background a little bit this season. Mario Addison led the team in sacks with 7. But there's Hughes making his presence felt here in the first round of the playoffs.
Yeah, they don't have that one dominant sack master, but they have a bunch of guys that can get it done in that department. Rousseau finished with 4 sacks. Basham had 2.5. Jones on 3rd and 13, hangs in the pocket, throws underneath to Jacoby Myers, who's tackled at the 45. And there's 20 seconds left on the clock. Verizon Halftime Report, JB and the gang. Scores and highlights from earlier action. Huge win for the Cincinnati Bengals over the Las Vegas Raiders to advance to the divisional round. It's all coming up on the Verizon Halftime Report.
Josh McDaniels trying to find something that's going to work here on 4th down for New England. And look, going this game is no secret at all. Buffalo, they wanted to put the game in the hands of Mac Jones. Take away all the other outlets. They've done that pretty well so far. And New England, understand their margin for error much smaller, wanted to stay out of these situations. But here it is. The young rookie's got to throw the ball the rest of this game.
They will operate from the gun on a 4th and 5. Jones timing out, turning around for it, and Jacoby Myers with the catch, but they have to hurry here. It's down to 12 seconds, 11 seconds. Patriots are out of timeouts. And this time, Jones is going to spike it for real. Stops the clock with 6 seconds left as he tosses it to the official.
Look at Jacoby Myers winning on the route against Taron Johnson in the slot, and just looking back and reading where the ball was coming from his quarterback. It ended up becoming a back shoulder fade type of a route and a good play by Myers.
That ball may have been
moving, right?
Just a little bit. And right now New England's going to try a field goal from 44 yards away with Nick Folk. 15-year veteran. And a timeout called. That will not count for Folk.
Practice
he gets
snap.
A practice swing of the leg.
A second. It'll be 30 seconds.
If you're Buffalo, why not? They don't carry over. Folk has had good success here kicking in Buffalo throughout his career. 16 for 20 for his span.
Yeah, Folk has been so good inside 50 yards. Very dependable. Broke into the league in 2007. As a 6th-round draft pick, went to the Pro Bowl that year. Four yards away. Bailey the holder. Folk drives it, and he knocks it through. has not missed a field goal inside 50 yards since week one of the 2020 season, and the Patriots put some points on the board with 1 second left on the clock. So that's 55 consecutive regular season makes inside of 50 yards, and he gets it done here in the playoffs.
And a good drive for the rookie quarterback, Mac Jones, to get something on the board before the half. A big fourth down throw to Jacoby Myers kept the drive alive.
Teams are 2-8 in the playoffs with a rookie starting quarterback since 2010, Mac Jones. He's packed a lot in. He basically told us that his 1 year has felt basically like 2 years, smashing everything together experience-wise. Obviously at Alabama, played a lot of games, played in big games, and then the draft process, and then the responsibility of being a starting quarterback.
Really hasn't had much time off because of what you described. Win a national championship, go right into the draft process, right? Go into the OTAs, mini camps, and knew he would compete for the starting job when he was drafted. So that allows you to put more time in, right? You've got more motivation. Took the job from Cam Newton and never looked back.
And that one just rolls to the 7 yard line. Bills are not going to take any chances. And Buffalo has got the big lead at the break. Patriots, the largest halftime deficit in the team's postseason history. 27-3. Bills in front. End of the first half. Halftime is next after these first half highlights from Verizon and a word from your local station.
Verizon is going.
Well, the Bills are telling the world that they are little brother no more. Micah Hyde comes out of nowhere, snipes this pick from Nelson Agholor. Buffalo in total control at the half, 27-3. As we welcome you back to our New York studio and the Verizon Halftime Report, the official 5G network of the NFL, this is 5G Built Right Verizon. JB along with Boomer, Coach, and Phil, and a dominant first half from the Bills.
Yes, it is. And Josh Allen running that Buffalo offense, he was terrific in the first half. As you watch some of these plays, he's doing it with his legs and his arm in the open field. Matt Judon, nope, you can't get him. He's fast, he's big, and elusive on a big run there. Then avoids the tackle and then throws a soft pass to the back of the end zone to Dawson Knox. Then let's just see a little power with that arm. Accurate with power. And when you look at this game, the speed and talent of Buffalo, very evident. And that's one of the reasons why New England can't match it. That's why they're up 27.
Buffalo offense has over 300 yards right now. Isaiah McKenzie, the fastest guy in the field. And this really has nothing to do with the two quarterbacks. This has to do right now with the New England defense has no answer for that Buffalo offense.
I got to tell you, we talked about Mac Jones hitting the rookie wall. He's the only one who hasn't hit the rookie wall as far as I'm concerned. New England didn't come up to play. They're getting pushed around all over the field. And quite frankly, we're seeing the best of Josh Allen. Four possessions, four touchdowns.
Super wild card weekend started earlier today, Boomer.
And it did. Congratulations to the Bengals. They get their first playoff win in 31 years. How about this controversial play? Listen for the whistle as Joe Burrow gets rid of this ball, and before it's completed,
were you not happy with the performance? No.
I think that's a good crew. I think there's a lot of things that went in the game, right, both ways. A lot of things went both ways. They picked the one up on the one deal over there, and the ball came back. And so I got enough problems with my job. I can't do the officiating, too.
Did you hear a whistle on that play? Because it's been talked about.
I definitely never heard a whistle. No way.
I know.
Did you hear any kind of whistle or anything when you delivered that ball?
No, I didn't hear any whistle.
Yeah, of course they didn't hear a whistle. The NFL head of officiating, Walt Anderson, put this out. We confirmed with the referee and the crew on that play. They got together and talked. They determined that they had a whistle, but the whistle for them on the field was blown after the receiver caught the ball. We all saw it. We all heard it. We all know that the ball was caught after the whistle was already blown. They also said an erroneous whistle is not reviewable. So what we have found here is a loophole in the replay mechanism.
And just understand, if there was an inadvertent whistle, they should have replayed the down. And really what's happened right now, I think for the fan out there, is frustrating because we have technology that allows us to hear everything on the field. We have technology that allows us to go back to the league office and to get the play correct. But right now, because it doesn't fall, under the category of reviewable plays, we're not doing it. We need to open it up and match the reviewable plays with the technology that we have today. The same thing with play clock. Play clock goes down while there's a the official has to look here to there. We see it. The play clock, we see the ball snap. We have to match technology right now with what we're able to see as a fan at home.
I think Boomer said it right. Every year there's something that comes up, a rule or a situation just like this that it doesn't cover. Of course, it'll be covered next year. They'll make the correction. But it was tough on the Las Vegas Raiders. But the only thing I can say this, which I said earlier, at least it happened in the second quarter where they had a chance to come back and have a chance.
Hey, but man, the Bengals won a playoff game, guys.
Yes.
Yeah. This is great. This is great fantastic news. Come on, coach, get with it.
Listen, I am so happy for the Cincinnati Bengals, honestly, for Joe Burrow and what they've done right there. And you know, they're moving on to this thing in 1991, what, 31 years?
31 years, man.
Since they've won one.
Hey, let me just say this. The game plan for the New England Patriots, it doesn't matter how you draw it up. When you can't match the talent, you're going to have a hard time beating the other team.
Leslie Frazier's defense getting her done.
Yep.
Super Wild Card Weekend continues tomorrow with a triple header starting with the Eagles and the Buccaneers at 1 Eastern on Fox and the Niners and Cowboys duel at 4:30 right here on CBS and Nickelodeon. Then on NBC, the Steelers battle the Chiefs in primetime, and the weekend concludes Monday night with the Cardinals and Rams on ESPN. Well, Marquise Valdes-Scantling said 8 different, 17 is
good.
Good.
That's really good.
The Verizon Halftime Report continues.
CBS Sports presents the Verizon Halftime Report, the official 5G network of the NFL. This is 5G built right. Verizon.
Halftime in Buffalo with the Bills in front 27-3. We'll be back with the start of the second half after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Tune in February 13th, the biggest moment of the year, the Pepsi Super Bowl 56 halftime show featuring Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, Eminem, Mary J. Blige, and Kendrick Lamar. Getting ready for the second half here in Orchard Park, New York. The Buffalo Bills have got the lead on the New England Patriots 27-3. The Pats will have the ball to start the second half. Ian Eagle, Charles Davis, Evan Washburn down on the sidelines. We're getting ready for the second half.
Where'd you get the jacket?
What jacket? Oh, this.
Was that.
Yes. Hall of Famer Kurt Warner, you might have noticed, wore this a few weeks ago, and it hit the internet by storm. Kurt saw that we had this assignment, and Kurt now runs a program, Warner's Warmers. He just sends the jacket out to whoever needs it. I feel like I want Jiffy Pop popcorn. I don't know about you, if you're in the mood for that. This thing is very warm. Kurt Warner, that was Raiders at Browns. This is the same jacket. Kurt sent this to me. And let me tell you, not all heroes wear capes.
They wear these jackets.
They wear silver bullet puffers.
Well, let's talk about the game real quick.
Yes.
Kurt, a brother would like a jacket too. But anyway, moving on from that, the only way New England gets back in this game, that defense can't just stop Buffalo, but they have to get takeaways and create extra opportunities for Mac Jones and the offense, which have to be extra efficient in this half.
And the return by Olszewski is spun down at the 24. Thanks to Rich Eisen for coordinating the whole jacket thing. And we go down to Evan Washburn. I'm going to give this jacket to him.
Yeah, I could use that. As you would imagine, Ian, at the half, it was a brief conversation with Bill Belichick. He was just visibly frustrated with the way his team played in that first half. And simply put, they just have to play better. As for Sean McDermott, applauded the execution of his guys. I asked him specifically the message when you're up this big against New England at half. He said, well, they were down pretty big in a Super Bowl, and they found their way back, and that's all we need to know.
Evan, in that first half, Mac Jones, 10 of 16, 106 yards, the pick, the handoff to Damian Harris. This is what New England wanted to do to start the game, establish the run. It's a 3-yard gain. Matt Milano with the stop. A whopping 9.1 yards per play for the Buffalo Bills. 300 total yards for Josh Allen and company.
I mean, that yards per play number is staggering. in the NFL and especially in playoff football. Now, can Mac Jones, the rookie quarterback, create some big plays and get New England started here as they try and come back in the second half?
Take the handoff. Rush is coming. Jones flips it out in front. Stevenson with a first down. Strong catch and sprint. Jones had to deal with the pressure from Matt Milano, and they turned it into 10 yards.
And a nice call there by Josh McDaniels, because he knows this is a very hyped up defense for Buffalo, wanting to make play after play. They catch him in the blitz, getting after the quarterback, and use it against him. Mac Jones takes the hit, grabbed his left leg back into the fray.
Yeah, he felt that one as he hit the turf. New set of downs for New England to work with. Running play, Harris, strong gain as he gets clipped from behind. Shaq Mason, a key block up front, and Harris may need a moment. This defense, led by Leslie Frazier in his fifth year, head coach of the Minnesota Vikings from 2011 to 2013, number one in the NFL in total defense, number one in scoring defense. Both Frazier and Brian Daboll, the offensive coordinator, are scheduled for interviews for head coaching opportunities with the Bears and the Dolphins. Jones popped up in the air, intercepted. Levi Wallace in the right spot, off the ricochet. Henry, the intended target.
Leslie Frazier, the defensive coordinator, if he's interviewing for a job, all he's going to do is bring this tape with him to show what his defense is capable of doing. Matt Milano with the big tip, Wallace with the pick.
Second interception for Mac Jones, that one intended for Hunter Henry. And the Buffalo Bills take over. Temperature has dipped to 5 degrees, minus 7 wind chill. And Josh Allen in complete control for Buffalo. Hand off. Singletary stacked up. Gain of 2 with forward progress. We check out Next Gen Stats powered by AWS.
Well, how about this play? The first touchdown of the game. The longest play in 3 seasons on a passing touchdown in the NFL. Well over 9 seconds, approaching 10, and he throws that alley-oop up there for Dawson Knox to come down with. That's the product of a lot of off-field preseason extra time together to work that out.
Allen will work out of the shotgun, just underway here in the third. Protection is there. Allen sends it to Reggie Gilliam. Had just 3 catches during the regular season, picks up 4 yards after Duggar and Phillips combined to bring him down. It'll be 3rd and 4 here for Buffalo on the Bills' opening drive of the second half. First half is Edgins. Touchdown, 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 touchdown.
And look at the number of, look at the yards for the drive. There's Brian Daboll right in the middle in the gray hoodie. And he's a guy, as you just mentioned, will be interviewing for head coaching jobs. This is a tape he can bring with him to show the the next team what they're getting.
I think they're watching. 3rd and 4. Singletary, first down. Brian Daboll won 5 Super Bowls as a member of the Patriots coaching staff. Won a national championship under Nick Saban with Alabama.
Yes, their play caller there, the offensive coordinator. And how about this last play? Frankly, the last 2 plays. What did Josh Allen do on both of them? Got off of the primary targets downfield, went to the check down, took what the defense gave him, and fashioned it into a first down with nice job by Gilliam and then Singletary to move the sticks.
So the Bills keep it moving here now in New England territory inside the 45. Flip it to the outside. Singletary hit along the sideline by the veteran Devin McCourty. McCourty, who has had so much success with the Patriots, we asked him about coming back to the postseason. He said, look, after last year, you realize nothing is given to you. Getting back to this point means a lot. Getting back to the standard that this team is accustomed to You relish the opportunity. You try to take advantage of it. New England in a deep hole right now, 27-3.
Let's not forget, this was a team that started 2-4 before they started working.
In a deep hole right now, 27-3.
Let's not forget, this was a team that started 2-4.
Had so much success with the Patriots. We asked him about coming back to the postseason. He said, look, after last year, you realize nothing is given to you. Getting back to this point means a lot. Getting back to the standard that this team is accustomed to. You relish the opportunity. You try to take advantage of it.
Spencer Brown move, but look at Mitch Morse, number 60. That's the center who snapped the ball.
You called this earlier with McKenzie. The speed down the sideline. McKenzie gets shoved out of bounds. They're using everything available to, and everything is clicking for Buffalo.
Well, his speed is something else, but look what else.
Boy on Monday, Deacon Morse.
So Kennedy has a little brother.
Oh, yeah. We got next level information.
And he made it back to practice after the birth.
Swing it to the outside. Cole Beasley gets involved. Flag is thrown. Hit by Hightower. There have been four penalties against the Patriots, just one against Buffalo.
Pass interference. Offense number 88. 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
So it's Dawson Knox. Brings this one back. Clean game so far for the Bills.
They can't do everything right. Watch 88, some blocking the field before the ball is completed to Beasley. He can only be 1 yard downfield on that blocking. He was more than that. The officials correctly flagged that play. The first mistake by Dawson Knox tonight.
Last year, the Bills held off Indianapolis 27-24 in the wild card for their first playoff win in 25 years. Play action. Allen. Deep downfield. Wide open. Touchdown, Emmanuel Sanders. And the Bills are pouring it on. Josh Allen has taken it to another level.
Jawan Williams, number 33. Not only did he peek into the backfield the entire way while playing zone, he slowed his feet about 10 yards into the route. And Emmanuel Sanders, against a zone defense similar to Stephon Diggs earlier in the ball game, just ran past the man who was responsible for the outer third portion of the field. And if you do that, Josh Allen will find you.
Five possessions, five touchdowns. Allen with his third. And the only thing that hasn't gone according to plan has been extra points. Tyler Bass missed it. The pick leads to points. The separation for Sanders. Another touchdown on the board for the gunslinger, Allen. Back here at Highmark Stadium, one Bills drive in Orchard Park, New York. All the buildup, the buzz this week. You've been here for a few days, yes. Charles. It's palpable in this area what this game means, this matchup in particular, and obviously to get a packed house at home for a playoff game in Buffalo.
They've won the AFCs 2 years in a row, but until they did this, and until it's actually the job is complete with New England, with this crowd base, it's not done, right? New England is the goal. That's who you have to go through, even if you are the defending AFC East champs.
Kickoff from Bass, over the head of Olszewski, and a touchback. Next Saturday on CBS, college basketball conference matchups are heating up. We'll have a fantastic showdown. The SEC, two top 25 teams, 18th-ranked Kentucky takes on 4th-ranked Auburn. The day begins with a preview of that game and updates on all the news around college hoops inside college basketball coming up next Saturday here on CBS. Check your local listings for game time.
Yeah, condolences to Big Blue Nation. Loss of Joe B. Hall, their head coach.
What a class act.
And then they jumped on my Volunteers hard today.
Yep. Yeah.
Not cool. Not cool.
Put that in the background. And it's Buffalo 33, New England 3. Play action. Jones steps up. Jones over the middle, toss caught by Harris, spun down by Edmonds. 7-yard gain through the air.
And Ian, this is what we've talked about all year long with these teams who are so explosive. All the defenses say, we're going to make them earn it, make them run extra plays. Look at what they've done. 9 plays, 10, 10, 4 and 6. And look at the yardage, 70, 80, 80. So if they're exhibiting patience and still scoring like that, they're going to be very difficult to deal with down the stretch.
Jones handled there by Jacoby Myers, but short of the first down, hit by Taron Johnson on the play. It's the first playoff game for New England without Tom Brady since 1998. That was a wild card loss to Jacksonville. The Patriots' current radio analyst, Scott Zolak, was at quarterback that day.
12 players in the huddle. Offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Get confused on the substitution and what they were, what personnel they wanted in the game. Ended up with 12 in the huddle and got flagged for it. So we went for a third and very short. Now it takes it to about a third and five, third and six.
And you mentioned it early in the game. The last thing New England want to do, get into a track meet with Buffalo. 0-5 this season when allowing 25 points or more. They're not built to just go out and outscore you. Jones, 3rd and 7. And he drops it in the bucket to Kendrick Bourne. The catch and the run by Bourne. Trampled down inside the 30 by Jordan Poyer.
Don't let them tell you that they won't compete, no matter what the scoreboard. Bourne to the sideline. A nice throw by Mac Jones over the top of Dane Jackson. Look at that ball. And Bourne with a nice catch. And look, he's going to tack out more after it. 10, 15 yards after the catch.
And that's really his forte, the yards after catch for Bourne. They're trying to get Bourne involved in the run game. Takes the opening. First down for Kendrick Bourne. Hit by Levi Wallace on the play. 14 yards and a couple of plays to loosen up this Buffalo defense.
And got the quarterback leading. Watch Jones, number 10. He doesn't just come to the side. He puts a nice shoulder into the defender, Mario Addison, which allows Bourne to make the move and cut back for additional yardage. Young man out of Alabama competing all the way through.
There is an injured Buffalo Bill on the play. It is Mario Addison. We'll come back. Injured Bill got up on his own. They were checking out the shoulder area as he made his way to the sideline. Addison has had a big year for Buffalo. The edge rusher now in his 11th year in the league. First down. Now Jones throws it into traffic. Brandon Bolden in a crowd.
Looks like a good read by A.J. Epinesa, number 57, the defensive end. He sniffed out the screen and was in the vicinity and almost became the intended receiver.
Second and 10. 42nd playoff game under Bill Belichick for the New England Patriots. Obviously the most over that span. Green Bay would be number 2 at 28 playoff games. Stevenson in there. Shotgun for Jones. That's a fly. It's handled by Stevenson. Tossed down by Matt Milano. 4-yard pickup on the pass play.
Watch Milano to the left of your screen. 58. Just sits in coverage. Sits in there when Stevenson makes the cut. He's there at the catch to help haul him down. Went to college as a safety. Boston College, evolved into a linebacker, and as I said in the first half, has played at a Pro Bowl level this season.
Shifting out of the backfield, Jacoby Myers, 3rd down and 6. They go empty. Jones delivers to the sideline. Myers takes the hit. He's got enough for the first down inside the 5. Levi Wallace with the smack.
That's a nice read by the young quarterback, Mac Jones, because he saw that Jacoby Myers was going to be isolated on Matt Milano.
And as good a job as Milano's done this year, that's a linebacker on a receiver and a good route by Jacoby Myers to break away from Milano and make the catch.
Extra offensive lineman, first and goal for New England. Harris had three touchdowns the last time these two teams met. He's not going to get to the end zone there. A.J. Klein reads it perfectly with help. Under 5 minutes to play now in the third. 33-3, Bills. Buffalo has won three of the last four meetings against New England, including that Week 16 matchup, 31-22 in Foxborough. Bills went 6-3 at home this season, but all those wins were against non-playoff teams. Second and goal. Handoff. No, fake it. Jones directing traffic, and he skies it. Back of the end zone. Catch made by that guy, but he's not eligible.
And he had to make the catch because the coverage was so good off the play fake. Normally in those types of patterns, you're not going to have more than probably two in the pattern. And you're thinking the fake will take care of everyone. But look at the back of the end zone. Yeah, he's wide open. And look at him. He wants to heal us.
Yeah, need to give that back, sir. Third and goal. From the gun. Time is there. Jones pump and throw, and it glances off the hands of Jacoby Myers. The field goal here does you no good.
Yeah, got to go ahead and try and get a touchdown. And you see the throw inside to Myers, and it's on the back side of him. If that throw is to the front side of Myers, I think we're counting 6 points on the scoreboard, but him having to stop and go back and try and turn his body was enough to turn it into an incompletion.
Patriots this year 0-5 when they allow 25 points or more. They've given up 33 tonight. They're trying to get a touchdown on fourth and goal. Jones, soft toss, wide open. Touchdown, Kendrick Bourne.
They had everyone in this pattern. And Bourne, 84, inside the slot to the left of your screen, just breaks to the back part of the end zone. But with so many others in the pattern and so much extra going on, he got lost in the back of the coverage. And Mac Jones found him for the touchdown. Really nice drive there for the Patriots. Not looking at the scoreboard, just trying to execute, work their way downfield, and successfully.
Kendrick Bourne came over from San Francisco. Finished the season with 55 catches, 800 yards, 5 touchdowns.
Interesting, a career year for him here. You know his teammate was in college, Cooper Kupp at Eastern Washington.
Not bad.
Obviously had a career year this season.
11 plays, 75 yards. It took 4 minutes and 36 seconds. Nick Folk will come on for the extra point. So Mac Jones, his first career playoff touchdown. Cardona to snap it, Bailey the holder. And Folk right down the middle. 33-10, Bills. Mac Jones finally gets what he was looking for. Bourne by himself for the score. Aerial coverage of tonight's game provided by Goodyear. It's freezing in Buffalo. Everybody knew it would be very cold. The anticipation throughout the week when the weather report came out, it was a subject, obviously, with both teams. Nobody downplayed it. Everybody accepted what is the reality here. Question now for New England. Do you try an onside kick at the 4:12 mark of the third? I think the Bills are...
I don't think so.
They're planning for it just in case with that group up front.
You have to plan for it, but I'd be shocked if they did it because of the way the Buffalo offense works. Your hope is to settle back and then try to take it away somehow on defense.
Kick it away. Return man is McKenzie. Had some room to the outside, but couldn't quite get there. He gets tossed down. Short of the 25. Follow the Dutton family west in the new epic Paramount Plus original series, 1883, a Yellowstone origin story starring Academy Award nominee Sam Elliott, Tim McGraw, and Faith Hill. 1883, now streaming exclusively on Paramount Plus.
You know, the Dutton family did well on that trip. They voted Buffalo in January on their way out west.
Josh Allen doing well tonight, 223 yards through the air, 63 on the ground. Three touchdowns, two to Knox, one to Sanders. Fake the toss, it's a running play. Singletary has been outstanding. First down run for Singletary for 10 yards. Check in with Evan.
Guys, weather at the 25s here. It's been cool to see how Buffalo's approached staying warm on this sideline. Micah Hyde told us about this, and you're seeing it right now in that brown cooler, or should I say heater. That's chicken broth in there, replacing water for some of these guys. Hyde, who spent 4 years in Green Bay, said that's key, along with some other things. Get that chicken broth in there to keep you warm on this sideline. I'm going to grab some here for this fourth quarter.
I was about to say, you didn't already?
Yeah, bring that up. Evan, chair, play action, Allen, to Knox, stiff arm, oh, major toss down by Dawson Knox along the sideline.
Oh my goodness.
They got Adrian Phillips.
And Adrian Phillips is a tough guy, okay? Some of these things that happen doesn't happen just because you're dominating people. Adrian Phillips had over 100 tackles last year and led this New England Patriots team. Came and make a play. Dawson Knox with a nice hand in his chest to continue on.
And they just gave Phillips a healthy extension. That's how high they are on Phillips and how well he's fit in to this defense. Second down and three. Singletary waits, leans forward, and he comes up short of a first down. Needed three, got two. Hit by Phillips down low with the ankle tackle. Third and one.
And with this score where it is, this is an offensive line that I'm sure is telling Josh Allen, running plays, man. Running plays. Let's keep it going that way.
Number 72.
Look at that.
Yep. Matt Hawk has not been needed in this particular matchup.
He punted against the Jets, but the prior two games before that, zero punts as well.
Hey, we're good. We're
and
good.
He did not have a good day last week against the Jets. Third and one, Josh Allen takes it for the first down. 6'5", 237 pounds. Sean McDermott, when we asked him about this season, trying to put it into context, he said, the success of last season, it was the first time that a lot of their people went through that. And he quoted Kirby Smart, national championship with Georgia, the winds blow differently near the top. It's challenging to stay on that level. He acknowledged, hey, we didn't win the Super Bowl, but we had a great season, and now you have to maintain it.
Absolutely, because everyone's coming for you now.
Late rush, Allen waits. And a sidearm toss to Cole Beasley. First down, Buffalo into New England territory.
And he's been waiting to get involved. He saw what Isaiah McKenzie did at New England. 11 catch, 125 yards in his slot. Been waiting to get involved again. He got involved in a big way. Look at Josh Allen. Look at him change the arm angle, drop down, and still throw the tight spiral that he seeks each time he throws the football. Put it right on number 11, and he took it upfield.
That is nine straight completions for Josh Allen. And 33 seconds to play in the third. Motion man McKenzie shifts to the backfield. Toss it to him, McKenzie. And it gets those legs churning. And McKenzie can get up and out to the sideline in a hurry.
That should be another run for him. That was a lateral pass. That was not upfield. So that should count as another running play for Isaiah McKenzie, who's had success doing that tonight. Three carries now, 29 yards on the game.
And that one covered 7 yards. The Buffalo Bills up big on the New England Patriots after three. One quarter away from the divisional round for Buffalo. 33-10. Bills over the Pats. Breakdown Wildcard Weekend with the Pros Who Know on Inside the NFL, streaming Tuesday exclusively on Paramount Plus. Start of the fourth quarter. Ian Eagle, Charles Davis, Evan Washburn, the rest of our NFL on CBS crew, our cameramen and women who are out here in the bitter conditions in Western New York.
Big respect and appreciation.
Big time. Second down and three. Toss it. Singletary. Zigzag move. First down run. Mitch Morse. Good block.
And it was set up by Singletary because it looked like they had a stalemate. When they got to the outside, Morse, number 60 in blue. Here he comes. And look at the jump cut there. And that helped set up the block by Morse that made it effective. Singletary right there. Jump there and then back outside. And that allowed Morse to get the angle and Singletary to get to the outside.
Bungled up in Buffalo. Yeah. You're better off looking in the camera lens. It blocks the wind.
Thank you all for doing what you do.
And again, Singletary. It's a deliberate cut and gets extra yards. Four for Devin Singletary. And he's closing in on 100 on the night. Quarterback numbers, Mac Jones has been sacked twice, intercepted twice. Josh Allen has been nearly perfect for Buffalo.
So that means now in his last four games against New England, that's 11 touchdowns, zero interceptions for Josh Allen.
Buffalo Bills, first team in the Super Bowl era to score five touchdowns on their first five possessions in a playoff game. Second down and six. Allen caught. Touchdown, Gabriel Davis. A Buffalo barrage.
Second time tonight, they've run that skinny post, the bang eight. And Josh Allen off the play fake throws a shot into it. And Gabriel Davis bodies off the defenders. Dawson Knox did earlier to finish off the play in the end zone.
Six possessions, six touchdowns. Tyler Bass, it's good. And the Bills have put a 40 burger on the Patriots. Josh Allen. Four touchdowns through the air. He's got style. Yeah, Buffalo is back to the tune of 40-10. Yeah, you just get into your own world.
And it's a good one right now.
13:22 to go here in the fourth quarter. 445 yards of offense for the Buffalo Bills. Bass will kick it off. Bill Belichick told us we're going to have to play our best game to win against Buffalo. It has not been their best game. Olszewski, little stop and go, and he gets driven down at the 24-yard line. By Johnson.
And it hasn't just been the offense for Buffalo tonight. Remember, this is the first drive of the game. New England was driving. A beautifully thrown ball by Mac Jones. And look at the range by Micah Hyde. That changed the game. Later on, Matt Milano, the linebacker, flashes in front of Hunter Henry after he read the route. And Levi Wallace comes up the interception. Leslie Frazier, defensive coordinator, is leading the number one defense in the league. And boy, they're putting it on display tonight.
Stevenson runs into a wall at the line of scrimmage. Damian Harris has been held to 29 yards on eight carries. Stevenson, just his second carry of the night. Matt Milano has been all over the field for Buffalo.
Go back to that interception by High. You know, we say, you know, a lot of times you say, well, no one play changes a game. To me, that play changed the course of this game. New England was driving. That looked like an apparent touchdown. And he took it away, and Buffalo went right downfield and scored, and the race was on.
They use Stevenson in the flat, and he turns it upfield for a first down. These two teams are playing one another for the third time in the last 41 days, so that feeling of familiarity, both coaches acknowledged it, both quarterbacks acknowledged it. Your division rivals, you know one another, you know each other's tendencies. There are no secrets when you get to this stage.
And people are wondering, do you come up with something new for the... Well, you try and find wrinkles and you change a little bit, but the basics are there. As Mac Jones told us, you're not tricking anyone at this point. You have to out-execute him.
Play fake. Jones, the toss to Jakob Johnson. He drops the ball.
This is what it comes down to. When Coach Belichick talked about, we have to play our best game, that means you have to execute at a high level. You have to make every play that's available to you. Your margin for error is thin against a team with a high-powered offense. And plays like that epitomize what's going on here tonight for New England.
Matt Jones, 18 of 29, 197 yards, a touchdown, two picks. The Patriots this season are turning the ball over multiple times, 2-7. Catch made by Jacoby Myers, but a short gain on the play, 3 yards. With one turnover or fewer, Pats went 8-0 this season.
Have to be clean. And when they were in the midst of that 7-game winning streak, everything was working well. The defense was holding people down. That allowed the offense to click at their own pace, allowed the running game to take hold, and then Mac Jones to throw off a play action to open people downfield.
They hit the bye after that 7-game winning streak. Number one seed in the AFC.
9-4.
Third down and 7. Rush coming. Jones steps up. And he's dropped. Couldn't get away. Boogie Basham will get credit for it.
Young man out of Wake Forest. Came in as a second round pick here in 2021. First round pick was Greg Rousseau out of Miami. In 2019, they were 1-2 in sacks in the ACC. Rousseau with 15.5. Boogie Basham with 11.5. Rousseau, number two in the country behind Chase Young at that time. They wanted more speed along the defensive front. These youngsters starting to provide it.
Punt from Bailey. It is Micah Hyde. Lets it bounce, and it's going to roll. Hyde scoops it up. Turns the corner. Micah Hyde down the sideline. And tripped up as he crosses the 45. The veteran Micah Hyde from the state of Ohio went to Iowa. Then with the Green Bay Packers, now the Bills. He told us he hates the cold, but he keeps coming back to the cold every stop along the way. He nearly went the distance. 55 years to the day, Super Bowl I. That's Pat Summerall doing the interview with the headset on.
Number 72
is Tommy Doyle. Rookie out of Miami, Ohio. Backfield, Singletary and Gillian. Fake it. Allen looks downfield, rips it. Dawson Knox! And he's down just shy of the goal line. Allen delivers it over the head of Jackson and nearly got his third touchdown to Knox. And it would have been his fifth of the night.
Down by contact because Jackson was able to get a hand on him. But Buffalo not getting off the throttle at all here with this big lead. Went for a dagger shot right there and almost completed it.
Yeah, missed it by that much. Don Adams.
Agent 99.
First and goal. Handoff. Singletary. No, denied. It's Zach Moss. short of the goal line.
Guarantee that offensive line saying, run it again. Run it again. Let us try and move people.
Sean McDermott, fifth year as the head coach, and this Bills team has done a whole lot of winning, but this is a different category.
Consistency of winning now. Knowing that they are the target and owning up to it and handling it. Doyle, 72, back in again.
Take it. Allen flips it for the touchdown. It's a big man touchdown for Tommy Doyle. Highlight after highlight after highlight.
Doyle lines in, reports in eligible number 72, the big rookie out of Miami of Ohio. His skills aren't just moving people, he can catch the ball too. When he signed his contract with the Buffalo Bills, he did it in full uniform, including helmet. You think he was enthusiastic about joining this team? And now it pays off in a touchdown here in the playoffs.
And that one doinks through. Maybe the only thing that they're going to have to look at is Tyler Bass on these extra points, who has been so good this season. Tommy Doyle was a hockey player in high school in the state of Minnesota. Now he's got a playoff touchdown on his resume. -10 The Bills in front, the most points ever given up against Bill Belichick in the playoffs. That's a really tight shot of broth.
Is that the chicken broth?
That's the broth.
Guys, when it's a 37-point deficit, we go to the culinary arts. I can say that this is as good a chicken broth as I've had. The salt to consistency ratio, strong. It's going down smoothly.
Evan, the fact that your hair is held up in the elements is not a shock to anybody that knows you. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Super Hair and Super Wild Card Weekend continues tomorrow. Triple header concludes Monday night in L.A., then the NFL Divisional Playoffs presented by Intuit TurboTax Live. Kickoff next weekend on CBS, Fox, and NBC.
And these Buffalo Bills fans rooting hard for Pittsburgh going into Kansas City, because if they pull the upset, we get another post-game here, correct?
Charge timeout.
Mark.
Buffalo, the first. 3:30 seconds.
Timeout taken by Buffalo. Yeah, the Bills can host next week as the number 3 seed in the AFC. Well, this is perfection.
I mean, they've done it every which way. 10-10. There's a 9-play drive. They've had 3-play.
Wow. It's never been done in the postseason. 484 yards. It's been a Bills explosion.
And I would not be surprised now, finally, that Josh Allen would come out of this game.
Mm-hmm.
Get ready for next week.
8:31 to go. Mac Jones. Run it to Damian Harris. And he's down quickly, going up the middle for one. Hit on the play by Boogie Basham. Well, for New England, how are you going to judge this season? Finished 10-7 in the regular season. This was supposed to be a bridge year with a rookie quarterback. They spent a lot of money during the offseason to get the right pieces in place.
I think they were still feeling like that at 2-4. But that 7-game winning streak took expectations way high.
Pitch it, Stevenson. Outside run, leans in along that sideline. And out of bounds, just short of the first down. You know, when we asked Bill Belichick, Evan asked him a question in our chat. He said, hey, do you still get excited after all these years? Do the juices get flowing? He said, absolutely. We've worked over a year to get here.
Yes.
Started last January, get the right players in place, training camp. But he said The team was excited about the opportunity. But they lost 3 out of 4 to end the season. That gave some people some pause. First down run up the middle for Stevenson.
Remember during that 7-game winning streak, and when I said expectations really went sky high, they were not unrealistic during that 7-game winning streak because of the way the AFC was going at that time. Kansas City wasn't sprinting ahead of the pack at that point. Tennessee looked like they were vulnerable. Remember, New England decimated Tennessee when they came into play. So no one thought, oh, that's outlandish. But then down the stretch, some of the flaws showed and some other teams got right.
Fake the pitch. Jones puts that one low, incomplete. The other part of the equation, too, coming off the first meeting between these two teams, Buffalo was demoralized.
Yeah.
That was a low point for the Bills. It was a unique situation with the weather conditions, the winds whipping, and New England just decided, hey, we're going to jam it down your throats.
And they did. 222 yards and 46 carries, 164-yard run. The crazy thing was, as poorly as it went for Buffalo that night, they had a chance to win the last drive. So they knew they were hanging in there, but they weren't quite themselves.
Catch. Attempted curl by Bourne, and it gets hit by Matakevich. And I think if you talk to any Bills player, that was the low point. Yeah. They had some tough losses along the way. The Tampa Bay loss, you know, a game they could have won. That was the low point.
I think they felt like they got their footing the second half of Tampa Bay. Even though they lost the game, they felt like they came out of that like, okay, we're more ourselves again. And that's when the streak began.
Had the big win at Foxborough, and that started to pump some real life into their playoff hopes. Jones gets away, throws it. A high pass handled by Kendrick Bourne. He is short of the first down marker. Picks up 2 yards. It's fourth down for New England. We are under 6 minutes to play. Cam Lewis put the pressure on Mac Jones.
A lot of substitutes in for Buffalo, but all of them racing around with their opportunity to play playoff football. Almost got Jones in the pocket, and even when he delivered the pass, Saran Neal on the spot for the tackle on Kendrick Bourne.
So it's fourth and two. Brandon Bolden sets up to the side of Jones. Myers, the motion man. Jones throws for the first down, caught by Myers, his sixth catch of the night on 9 targets. Flag is down.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense number 57. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
And it's Epinesa.
Correct call. He didn't go all out and jam him, but the ball was long gone by the time Epinesa came and put hands on him.
First time in franchise history, the Bills finished with the number one scoring defense in the league. They forced the most 3 and outs in the league this season.
But Sean McDermott's going to get a lot of praise, and rightly so. Leslie Frazier should be getting a lot of attention for what he's done with that defense. Brian Daboll with the offense. But Josh Allen's development doesn't happen without Ken Dorsey as well, the quarterback's coach.
Yes.
I mean, that they've been into, you know, locked at the hip as well and getting his mechanics right. The evolution of him in terms of being more patient, taking more checkdowns, he's really helped develop his game.
Delayed handoff, Stevenson veers on that cut and crosses the 30-yard line, hit by Cam Lewis. Tomorrow, NFL Super Wild Card Weekend continues. Epic battle between two legendary NFC teams. Another chapter will be added to one of the game's most historic rivalries. The 49ers take on the Cowboys. Our coverage begins 4 o'clock Eastern. NFL Today, Super Wild Card Weekend, tomorrow on CBS. Second down and 3, another running play. And Stevenson gets spun down after picking up a couple. Ed Oliver there defensively. Yeah, we mentioned number one scoring defense in the league. 4 of the 8 previous teams to lead the NFL in total defense and scoring defense, which Buffalo did this season, went to the Super Bowl. The Bills' offense is high powered. It's dynamic.
And then you put that with it?
Yeah, that's the balance. Now, you look around the NFL, you're trying to find balance. This Buffalo team is as balanced as anybody. Stevenson, first down run. Clock moving, 3:22 and counting. Coming up after the game, State Farm postgame show. JB, Phil, Boomer, Coach Cower. They'll have highlights. They'll have scores. They've got it coming up on the State Farm postgame show.
I chuckled a little bit when we showed that San Francisco-Dallas game coming up tomorrow. Kyle Shanahan tried to indoctrinate his 49ers about that rivalry in the 90s. Got nothing but blank looks about it.
Really?
His players were like, that was a thing? San Francisco-Dallas?
Yeah, on YouTube. Look it up. Catch and run. Aguilar gets walloped along the sideline. Basham and Jaquan Johnson collaborate. But it's first and goal for New England.
Nice pass back. Nice play design, execution, and big hits at the end.
First and goal. Stevenson stood up. Driven backwards, Damar Hamlin leading the charge. Rookie out of Pitt. And we hit the 2-minute warning here in Buffalo. Josh Allen, 5 touchdowns through the air. The Bills have been strong from the word go tonight. Second down and goal inside the 5 for New England. Jones in the pocket, throws it too high over the head of Jacoby Myers. So third and goal for the Patriots, 1:55 to play. Cam Lewis back there defensively for Buffalo.
Cam Lewis blocked the punt against the Jets. Now getting his chance to play some defensive snaps.
You know, interesting when we mentioned the season to the likes of McDermott and Josh Allen, the bumpy road, everybody had the same theme, which was, no, made us stronger. We feel better about ourselves having gotten through it. Third and goal. Jones. Incomplete. Hunter Henry had a sure touchdown. Low throw. Henry tried to go down and get it. No catch. That kind of night.
It is that kind of night. And on a night where, as time goes on, the temperature drops, ball gets a little slicker, your hands not quite as supple. Hunter Henry unable to come up with that one. He'd gone through a season. I don't remember him recording a drop until that play.
Fourth and goal. Jones to the back of the end zone. And the catch is made for the touchdown, Kendrick Bourne. Well, the Patriots get some window dressing here at the tail end of the fourth quarter.
Bourne and does a nice job going from inside out after coming in on short motion. Did a nice job with a little deft hand movement against the body of Cam Lewis to get away from him. And a nice throw by Mac Jones. Putting it right over the top. Bourne with good possession. Rips it away for the touchdown.
Send out Folk for the extra point. Just making sure that was clean. Confirmed. So Mac Jones will finish the night with 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions in his playoff debut. 232 yards, 24 of 38. Buffalo. 47-17, Buffalo. Don't forget the State Farm postgame show. JB and the gang back in New York. The latest NFL scores and highlights coming up on the State Farm postgame show. So part of the learning process for Mac Jones. He's got a lot of pride. Jones had a terrific season in his rookie year. You know, we asked him about the familiarity with an opponent. Ever play anybody three times? He said, yeah, Pop Warner. I faced Sweetwater Athletic Association three times, the Hawks. In fact, his current teammate, Sean Wade, was on that squad. And you asked him, well,
how'd you do?
How'd you do? He said, we did okay.
He was trying to play it off.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah,
I thought he was being modest.
He said, I think that year, felt like they swept them that year, but he said they played multiple years.
Yes.
They didn't win all of them, but they won the majority of them.
But it is a unique situation.
It really is. It absolutely is. And the reason he was in the game this late is because of that growth and development. And they wanted him to go through all of these things in his rookie year. Plus, he's going to feel this all offseason, motivating. You know, bring him back, his teammates back, work harder in the offseason, try and get ready. Because right now, Buffalo runs the AFC East.
Yeah, and he told us, you know, as the season went along, you get to show your teammates who you are, developing relationships. And he felt like he earned his stripes.
Yeah.
And he could get to the point where he was having honest conversations with his guys as a rookie starting quarterback. Took a big bounce. McKenzie is there, and he goes down with a minute 42 to play in this fourth quarter. So, in the AFC, Cincinnati advances. 26-19 win over Las Vegas. A breakthrough victory for that franchise. The Buffalo Bills will move on. Tennessee will play the lowest remaining seed as the number one seed. All part of the divisional round presented by Intuit TurboTax Live. And you still have Pittsburgh and Kansas City tomorrow night. Mitchell Trubisky in. He takes a knee. And the final moments here in Western New York. What a performance by the Buffalo Bills and Josh Allen. Five touchdown passes. Allen was money. 307 yards through the air. 65 rushing yards. He said to us to have this experience at home with their fans. It's been a long time coming for this city to have a packed house for a playoff game. He told us how pumped he was for it, and his play reflected that. Bills players asking the fans for their emotions to come through. It's harder to cheer on a cold night like this. You're wearing gloves. You don't hear the claps, per se.
But you can hear their voices.
You can. And a signature win for Sean McDermott. The Buffalo Bills stampede into the divisional round. They beat up on the Patriots 47-17. Buffalo moving on. And they look ready for this from the very start. Josh Allen, masterful once again against New England. They ended the season on a four-game winning streak, and you could feel that confidence in this wild card matchup.
They look like a team ready for any challenge now. They look like no matter what's in front of them, they have the type of team that is ready to play that game. Complimentary football. Offense, defense, they've got it.
They scored 25 points or more in 13 games this season, the most in the NFL. Well, tonight, they explode. 47 points in a wild card rout against New England.
Care how much you practice, how much you draw it up. You don't think seven possessions, seven touchdowns, and they did it.
Good. Down to the field, Evan Washburn.
Well, Josh Charles Davis, or as you like to call him, Chuck, just said it. 7 touchdowns on the first 7 possessions of this game. How'd you do it against this defense?
We had guys coming out here. We were ready to play. Good week of practice. A lot of preparation went into this one. Guys made some unbelievable plays, offense, defense, special teams. We start off really fast with the touchdown, and Micah with the unbelievable play there in the end zone. We just kept the momentum rolling all day today, and we were happy to get this one.
For you, how would you describe the command you have of this offense as we head into this postseason?
I think we feel good. There's some things that we can clean up and work on. But at the end of the day, we moved on. We're to the next one. And it doesn't matter what we did today. It's what we do next week. And, again, we gotta put our foot forward and be ready for the next one.
Yeah, I get the one-track mind, but let's sit into what we just experienced, because we talked here last year. It was about 6,000 fans. Now you got a full house, a playoff win. What was this atmosphere like for you?
It was awesome. I mean, these are the best fans in the world. They deserve it. To share this experience with them, to hear the energy and the excitement in this building today, it was unbelievable. Extremely blessed and honored to be part of, obviously, the Buffalo Bills and Bills Mafia here. They've been awesome, and hopefully we can get one more. We'll see.
You went sleeves. A little cold, huh?
I went sleeves. I caved in. I think it worked out, though.
Absolutely. Congrats. We'll see you down the road.
Thank you. Go Bills.
All right, Evan, Josh Allen, not only saying all the right things, but leading this team in the right manner, week in, week out. Final score in Orchard Park, 47-17. The Buffalo Bills dominate the New England Patriots. Coming up next, State Farm postgame show. For Charles Davis, Evan Washburn, the rest of our crew, Ian Eagle, saying so long from Buffalo. We'll send you back to James Brown in New York right after this.